What's up, everybody? My name is Vincent. Welcome to Cryptolution, where we talk about everything under the moon in the crypto universe. Guys, thank you so much. We have officially reached 500 subscribers. Thank you guys for your support, following us for these few months. Since we've opened the channel, we've been getting a lot of amazing comments, and your support for this channel has paid off. Thank you so much. Today, guys, before we dive in, we're going to be talking about Solana. Why Solana is one of the only cryptos in the top 10 on CoinMarketCap that is still in the green in terms of the 24-hour trading. So with that said, guys, before we begin, be sure to like that button, hit that subscribe button, hit that notification bell so that you're notified on these time-sensitive videos. And also, please leave a comment down below to let me know what your thoughts are on Solana or any other crypto coins that I should be looking at. Now, with that said, let's begin. So, as you're aware, Solana is $182, and just yesterday, $173, and just a few days before that, $150. Why is that? While the other markets around like Ethereum and other coins are a little bit down, mainly because Bitcoin, you know, went up to 66K and then dropped down to 62 at the current moment, and Ethereum was at 4,200, now it's at 4,000. But why is Solana so hi, why is there money flowing in? Well, we're going to dive deeper into that. And I want to make a point. Right now, the total market cap for the global market cap of the cryptocurrency market is $2.57 trillion. Now, the reason you need to know why that's important is because a lot of the money, especially with Bitcoin, if Bitcoin drops to 62,000 and there's still money flowing in, that means there is money flooding the market. That means that there is money flowing into these altcoins, not just Bitcoin. And that's huge because, you know, people were expecting that Bitcoin was going to have its run while altcoins were going to lag behind, and then Ethereum was going to get its run, and then altcoins were to follow. But that does not seem to be the case now. And I think it's because the Bitcoin ETF, futures ETF that was passed by ProShares, and then next week, Valkyrie is going to have their Bitcoin futures ETF live to trade, is getting a lot of interest from the media, and also the media is getting interest from the public, and that all funnels into the cryptocurrency market. And guess where people are putting their money into? I mean, they're putting their altcoins all over the place, but also Solana. They're putting their money in Solana. Solana had flipped XRP, which is huge, already up $4 billion from XRP. And guess what? Solana is coming for Cardano next. So just know that I'm a Cardano holder as well. So I'm not trying to show Solana so much or put hate towards Cardano. I love Cardano fans. I love the Cardano army. So let's dive into what's going on. So right now, there are a couple articles that are giving different price predictions. So this one says Solana gains over 26% in 2 days. $250 price of each SOL is the next target. I mean, that's one way of seeing it, right? Because right now, you know, we saw a symmetrical triangle, and it was bouncing up and down, meaning it was some consolidation. And just know that when it was going up this high, you know, we needed to take a breather, and it did give us that breather. And now we're into the October time, and right now we did have a breakup because of all this bullish news. And so it was almost quite healthy to see this trading sideways and consolidating, because it needed to breathe after this huge uptrend on price. So this is what this article says, is basically saying 250 is the SOL target, right? So another article brings up that it could even go up 700% by 2022. And we're gonna go further down. It says, from a technical perspective, the daily and weekly charts both show an interesting yet bullish outlook for Solana's price. The daily time frame shows SOLs rose 713% between July 21st to September 8th. Forming a flagpole, the first element in a bullish flag or pennant pattern. This exponential growth was followed by consolidation that created three lower highs and higher lows, resulting in a pennant forming that when connected using trend lines. Taken together, the run-up from July 21st to October 20th and the consolidation that followed is a continuation pattern known as a bullish pennant. This technical formation forecasts a 713 upswing to $1,336. And I will tell you this, in a previous video, I had predicted that price as well. Obtained by adding the flagpoles distant to the breakout point at 164. Solana's price shattered the pennant's upper trend line on October 20th and has rallied 21% to where it currently is. Going forward, investors can expect SOL to continue its 713% uptrend to reach its theoretical target of $1,336 or more conservative, $721. So what does that mean? So basically, they took the level of this 713% uptrend, right? From the low to the high, and then they took that line and put it over here. And when we made our video, we had kind of set it around this moment, but again, it was taking a breather. But again, it was right around here, the almost exact same price that I had predicted of where we're gonna go. And if this doesn't happen by November, I do expect it to go closer to December. Can it go up to $1,000? I absolutely believe so. But I think more conservatively, we should consider that Solana could reach as high as $500 to $700. That's my conservative lowest ballpoint. And with that said, if it reaches $500, $700 and you bought in at $73, even $123, maybe even right now, $180, that's a good time to take some profits, right? And I'm not saying sell your whole Solana bag, but take a little bit off the top and have some cash converted into USDT so that you can have some money on the side to buy dips, because dips will happen. That's just how markets are, especially in the cryptocurrency world. When everything's come up, they have to come down, and that is good for cryptocurrency investors. So again, there's more money flowing in, and there's also being having more money being raised for platforms built on Solana blockchain. One of them is Synchrony. Synchrony raises $4.2 million to build asset management protocol on Solana. And what that is the project is building a marketplace to allow users to replicate trading strategies across the Solana ecosystem. Through the Synchrony interface, users will adjust parameters for trade execution and leverage in-depth analytics. Again, people are raising money on the Solana blockchain. They are building on the Solana blockchain because it's so fast and efficient. This is the Web 3.0, while Ethereum is the Web 2.0 and kind of Cardano at the same time. They were almost made closer in terms of their calendar years. And Solana only this year in 2021 has been growing substantially. So what else is there going on? Well, guess what? A 14-year-old made over $400,000 by selling a whale NFT. Yes, NFTs are huge on Solana, and it's still early, and there's a lot of NFTs on Solana that are affordable that will hopefully boom up in price, hopefully by next year. The high school freshman and YouTuber plans to donate part of her profits to beluga whale conservation organizations and children hospital program. I love seeing money being paid for the art that they've created. The 14-year-old Abigail, also known as Peach Sunday in the realm of digital art, has sold approximately $435,000 worth of non-fungible tokens via the Solana network. Her network, known as Belugies, was posted on Alpha Art, an NFT marketplace that allows users to purchase and trade Solana NFTs for free. And if you want to check out other NFT platforms, check out solanaart.io and also ftx.us. They have an NFT marketplace, and a lot of it is Solana right now. I have not seen any Ethereum NFTs on there or any other NFTs from cross-chain networks such as AVAX, Cardano. Right now it's just Solana. Continuing, with different characters to select from in Abigail's collection of 8,000 NFTs to drop, the top NFT sold for 300 SOL, then 299, then 125, then 100, then 75 SOLs. Majority of these sales are on the white belugi, which retailed at an average sale price of 1.81 SOL. That is great. I love seeing people who are new. It doesn't matter how old you are, as long as you're an artist, this is a huge time for you to get involved and sell your artwork. So that's one amazing story. And the last one is Solana gaming platform Monkey Ball raises $3 million. And I've been talking about play-to-earn games built onto Solana. They're going to be huge. You need to get in early. And so right now, play-to-earn gaming platform Monkey Ball has confirmed the conclusion of its recent funding round, during which it managed to raise over $3 million from a slew of venture and angel investors. What are they? There's Solana Capital, Republic, NFX, iAngels, Longlash, CMS, Jump Capital, UB, Morningstar Ventures, Banter Capital, Incentive Assets, Market Across, Node Capital, ZBS Capital, Metaversal, Collider, BFF, Six Man Ventures. I mean, that's a lot of people. And so one of the members of DraftKings said, the play-to-earn games are a revolution in how gamers interface with the virtual world. Gaming and NFTs will be the first true mass appeal application of blockchain. All that is missing is actually to make a game that would stand tall along AAA titles. And when we talk about AAA titles, we're obviously talking about really big companies. In fact, there are some companies out there, say for instance, Steam has banned any NFT games, any play-to-earn games on their platform. It's because they're a big company, so they don't want to allow this new chain to get the upper hand because it's going to steal their market cap. The article continues, I believe the Monkey Ball team has what it takes to go there. Thank you, Shalom, for that honest opinion. The article continues to say, a fast-paced, play-to-earn arcade soccer game Monkey Ball sees players compete in games featuring teams of larger-than-life monkeys. Tokens are rewarded for each victory, and there are additional earning opportunities for those who buy stadiums and host matches. So buying stadium hosting matches is like an NFT. It's like buying land. It's just like Sandbox and all these other play-to-earn games, which is, you know, when you own something massive, you can host these games, and you bring in the appeal of other users, and that in some way gives you token rewards in that regard. And who knows, maybe you can sell that NFT or that land or that stadium to somebody else for a higher value. So again, really early on in the stages, but these NFT play-to-earn games are revolutionizing the gaming industry, and the billions of dollars that actually go into the real gaming industry in the physical world are going to transmute over here because players want to earn money rather than just spend money and not get anything back. This is their ball field. So this is great for the blockchain, especially for Solana. Solana is fast. So guys, with that said, in my opinion, Solana is gonna do quite well in the next couple months, and who knows, may go further. We will always keep you updated with Solana and every other cryptocurrency out there. Right now, I've been bullish on Solana. I hold Solana. I hold a ton of it, and it's just something that I feel so positive about. I've been with Solana since it was $33, and you know, is it too late to invest right now? If you're asking, because the price is at 182, I don't say it is. I would say always dollar cost average. Don't put $182. Put $20, $40, $50. Again, none of this is financial advice, only financial opinion. But in my opinion, that's what I'd be doing, and that's what I have been doing since Solana's been at $33. And ever since then, I've been a profit. And every now and then, I'll be negative by very little, not so much. It's not one of those cryptocurrencies that I feel bearish about. I do feel like Solana is going to eat Cardano and Ethereum's market cap, and we don't know when Ethereum is going to launch their 2.0 proof of stake mechanism, because honestly, that's not going to happen until, from what we hear, until June 2022. That could change, but until then, the next 2 to 4 months, Solana is going to be eating up everything, and that Solana price should go up to $500 to $700, and at most around the $1,300 level. So with that, guys, that is all I have to offer you. Please subscribe. We want to hit the next goal of 600 subscribers, and be sure to like that button, hit that notification bell, and hit the subscribe button, guys. Thank you so much for your support, and I will see you guys next time.